Yo, everybody in a couple of my videos, I guess not everybody, but people in my videos always say that I should react to Dax. He dropped the Godzilla, he dropped whatever, and it's fire. Go check it out, make a reaction. There's a reason why I don't react to Dax. I just don't find him that entertaining to me. And you know that we keep it 100 over here, so let's talk about why. Roll it. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Channel's name is The Third Ernest. I'm Ernest Adriano the Third. Y'all guys are the third family. If you like what you see, consider becoming a part of the family, click and subscribe button bottom right hand corner. Now today's video is a little bit different than my normal video. Normally I put out reactions. This is more of like a commentary type video as to why I don't react to Dax or why I don't find Dax as entertaining. He's obviously talented. There's just something about him that just turns me off completely to his music. And it's not something, it's some things. I better turn that ringer off because that's gonna piss me off. Now I know the boy has bars and I know he can spit, and that's what makes my feelings for him even more frustrating for me, because I'm all about that life, as you know if you've been here on the channel. But the only thing that's more important than spit on this channel are the vibes. And if there's something that's off about your vibe, it doesn't matter how hard you can spit. And I know that this might ruffle a couple of feathers. I know that this might kind of get toward a couple of Dax fans. And yo, that's par for the course with these type of videos. So let's get into why I'm not really too big of a fan of Dax. Because there are legitimate reasons. And reason number one is his marketing. When I first found Dax, it was after he did, I think it was the Rap God One Take Breakdown. I even made a video about that. That was like one of my first videos, and he actually liked it. Now that I think back on it, it probably wasn't him. It was probably his team, considering he had like 800,000 subscribers on Instagram. But I was like, yo, this dude's got potential. This dude's got mad flow. He's got mad bars. His pen game is strong. But as I followed him, he planted a seed in my mind that grew bigger and bigger and bigger, and it was unavoidable at a certain point. And that it's that the dude is mad corny online. People say that Logic is corny, and I can understand that because he's kind of got like this corny gamer type vibe about him, but Dax is on a whole nother level. As soon as I saw him start tweeting about like, I'm sick, he started tweeting about some pills he was taking, and then he started tweeting about his skin color turning purple, and then the whole like month-long marketing campaign ended up with Daxnos? Fucking Daxnos. You couldn't come up with some type of alter ego that's stronger than just taking Thanos and then putting Dax and Nos together. Daxnos doesn't even flow. Like the word just doesn't even go together. Daxnos. It's like hard to say. And all of that buildup for you to be like, yo, take me serious. I got something wrong with me. My skin, all yada, yada, yada. And then we end up with fucking Daxnos. And that wasn't even the first time. The first time that I had caught on like, yo, this shit might be a little corny, was when he was like pretending that he was gonna go through law. He pretended he was gonna become a policeman. He's like, yo, it's the biggest, most important thing in my life. And then all of a sudden, it's just like promo for a music video that he shot. I don't really ever call people tryhards, but Dax, when it comes to his marketing and attempts to go viral with social media marketing, fucking tryhard, bro. Like, you ain't gotta be doing all that. Your flow is good enough to speak for itself. Just be talking like a normal person. Yo, I got these bars, I'm about to spit, y'all need to go check it out. That shit will go viral on its own because your flow is that good. But then when you come out of here with fucking Daxnos, it completely takes all the wind out of your fucking legitimate flow. How does this person who has this fucking flow, who has this creativity with the pen, come up with fucking Daxnos? That shit just perplexes me. And the fact that I personally believe, like when he responded to my DM, now I personally believe that it wasn't him DMing, that just goes and leads on to the next thing that I find wrong with Dax. And it's not that I find wrong with it, it just like, it doesn't sit right with me. It irks me on the inside a little bit. And that's his fucking personality. And this is actually when things kind of started to fall apart for Dax on the internet. Now, I'm not too familiar with everything that happened like last summer with all like the YouTube rappers that had like beef with Dax. I don't really keep up with YouTube rap that much. But when he had that beef with them, after we saw some like messages and things like that, I wasn't really sure like if it was a legitimate type beef or if what he did was actually legitimate, because I do know that Screw's fan base, they can be pretty relentless at times. So I was like, oh, maybe it's just Screw's fan base blowing shit out of proportion because they always get a little rowdy, it seems like, his fan base. Or I was like, oh, maybe it's Crip's fan base was just being too loyal to Crip and not being able to look at both sides of the coin, both sides of the picture, to figure out and decipher what's really going on. Because I know Crip's fan base can be extremely loyal to who he is as a rapper and who he is as an artist, but after a certain amount of time, when it's like not even just the two fan bases anymore, it's people who don't even have skin in the game, it's just normal, like, casual rap fans, people who look up reactions on YouTube, people who watch YouTube rap and listen to YouTube rap, after like the entire conglomerate is saying the same thing, the perception might not actually be who he is, the perception might not be the true reality, but in the grand scheme of things, perception is reality. And from what I remember, at least just the little pieces that I gathered online and things like that, is that he never really came to his own defense against the things that were being said about him. Now, the whole diss between Crypt and Screwface Jean and everybody forming a like fucking boy band of YouTube rap to go after Dax, that shit was mad corny to me. But still, when Dax is trying to get a foot in the game and trying to be bigger than a YouTube rapper, and here we have his colleagues saying all these things about him, which if they were untrue, you would think that he would want to go and defend his own honor. Like, if it were me in the rap game and I'm on the potential come up, I'm the biggest YouTube rapper that's out there right now that has the biggest potential to get an actual record deal, you would think that while I'm on that come up, if someone came in and said something about me that would potentially discourage an entire fan base, that would potentially discourage an entire new level of listener that has never heard about me, you would think that I would want to respond and say that shit is untrue. Doesn't even have to be in the form of a diss, it could just be in the form of like a tweet, or it could be in the form of an Instagram story or whatever, but I didn't see any of that. And for anybody that knows anything about rap, there's really only two things you have as a rapper. It's only what you say on the mic, it's only your pen game, and it's your balls. It's who you are as a person. So if someone is coming after the integrity of you as a person and you don't defend yourself, perception is reality at this point, fam, regardless if it's the true reality or not. And that shit just like left like a bad taste in my mouth, as it did with a lot of people. But at the end of the day, those two things don't matter when it comes to what you say behind the mic. And the problem is that I even have issues with his raps. And that's the most frustrating thing, because he's obviously a mad talented rapper. And the first thing that I have a problem with when it comes to listening to his raps is his delivery. It's the same fucking delivery every single time. And that shit, no matter how good your pen game is, if your cadences don't switch up, if your vocal flow and your style and the way you enunciate words doesn't switch up every here and there, that shit gets mad boring. I don't care how good your bars are. Imagine the people that are just casual rap listeners that are not the greatest at catching bars, that take 6, 7, 8 times to listen to a song to catch everything that you're saying. If it takes them that long and then they get bored with the delivery, they're never gonna make it to the 6, 7, 8 time to listen to the same song because they get bored, and it's easy to get bored when the lyrics are complex. It's the same thing that I've said about Eminem. Ultimate complexity in new school Eminem, boring, fast-paced delivery, is a disconnect with the casual rap fan. And Dax falls into that same trap. The maybe 6 or 7 songs that I've heard from Dax that have blown up on the YouTube and they've got millions of views and they went viral on Twitter or whatever, same delivery every time since the very first one that I heard when he did his one take freestyle. And speaking of the one take freestyle over an Eminem beat or over a very popular beat, that's another thing. Most of his most popular music comes from using an instrumental that somebody else made famous. And to be fair, it's not just Dax. Riding in the wake of Eminem's career with his musical instrumental choices, and then You Go Hard on top of that, and then those are your most popular songs on the internet. I don't know if that's because of you, or I don't know if that's because the stans that come in and want to hear somebody go on Eminem's beat, or I don't know if that you're just getting clicks because it's Eminem's beat. So is it really you as a rapper that's furthering your career by showing people that you got what it takes? Or is it everybody wanting to see if someone could rap just as fast as Eminem on Godzilla? It's the same issue that Joyner Lucas was falling into before he was able to climb himself out of that hole of just being a good freestyle rapper over somebody else's beat. He might have gained popularity with those freestyles, but he was able to put out his own original tracks that had their own original concept and gain their own traction underneath their own merit. Because at the end of the day, the bars are only half of the formula. You need to be able to put the second half, which is the instrumentation, which is the instrumental, the beat, which is the production. You need to be able to put those two together in order to create something brand new, fresh, and original. And Dak, so far, only has half of it. And that half that he does have, even then, is lackluster because all it is just spitting bars with no substance. That's only gonna get you so far. And to be honest, the distance that it's gonna get somebody like Dax, he's already reached it. So now he's gotta go past that. And lastly, and maybe this goes with the personality thing, the last thing that irks me is that he talks like he's already walked the walk, and he has not. Getting a couple million views per video on YouTube is not walking the walk. And the worst part about it is that he has the talent for everybody to know his name. He has the talent to go deep into the game. And people are probably gonna think that I'm just shitting on Dax. I'm not just shitting on Dax, because I truly believe in the dude. I believe that he can be as great as he says he's gonna be. You might hate Dax as a person. You might hate what he did in the whole YouTube beef, yada, yada, yada. I don't give a shit about any of that. You better respect the man's pen game, because you know that it's vicious. But a vicious pen is not all that it takes to make it to the level that he's talking about that he wants to make it. But yo, that's it. If I ruffled some feathers, if this is a hot take, I don't give a fuck. If you feel that I'm wrong and you have facts that I don't have, and you present those facts in the comments, and I'm like, oh, okay, shit, you're right, I agree with what you're saying, I'll let you know. I'll be mad enough to say that I was wrong, or maybe that I misread or misjudged some part of what I'm saying. But at the same time, if you feel that I'm right, go ahead and leave it in the comments as well. But that's it, guys. Thank you for watching this video. If you like what you saw, please consider becoming part of the family. Click and subscribe. Please consider liking the video and leaving a comment. All those different things help the algorithm catch the video and send it out for the masses to view. Peep the Discord down in the links below. Peep the social medias down in the links below in the description. And that's it. Like I always say at the end of all of my videos, guys, go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other, and I'll catch everybody on the next video. Peace.